Welcome back to the Republicans Now. They say a picture is worth a thousand words. Well, is it worth a thousand votes? Maybe more? Donald Trump is betting much more. The Republican frontrunner has been uncharacteristically quiet the past few days as his campaign undergoes a reboot of sort. But he dropped by the 9/11 Museum in Manhattan on Saturday, something he hopes is a powerful silent message to any New Yorker thinking about supporting Ted Cruz. Remember, just last week, Cruz won big in Wisconsin, but he can't count on that momentum carrying over to the critical fight for New York and its 95 Republican delegates. He's from Texas, evangelical, Tea Party. So a steep hill anyway. And then there's this.
Everyone understands that the values in New York City are socially liberal or pro-abortion or pro-gay marriage, focus around money and the media. And I guess I can frame it another way. Not a lot of conservatives come out of Manhattan. I'm just saying.
Well, the New York Daily News didn't forget. You see it there offering Senator Cruz some rather colorful subway advice. And of course, before he went quiet, neither did Trump.
So I looked at him and started talking about incredible firefighters. Our incredible people are unbelievable construction workers. Who could have done that? Who could have rebuilt that hole? There was never anything like it in this country. The worst attack in the history of the United States. The bravery that was shown was incredible. We all lived through it. We all know people that died.
Senator Cruz is standing his ground, though choosing his words a bit more carefully.
The people of New York know exactly what those values are. They're the values of liberal Democratic politicians like Andrew Cuomo, like Anthony Weiner, like Elliot Spitzer, like Charlie Rangel, all of whom Donald Trump has supported, given tens of thousands of dollars throughout the year.
All right, so I think it's safe to say New York is not the most welcoming territory for Ted Cruz. But Sarah, let's start with Donald Trump. He has been uncharacteristically quiet. He's having what I call an adult intervention. Mm-hmm. He has a new hired hand, Paul Manafort, who is trying to convince Donald Trump to change some things. Keep the essential Trump, but change some things. He's back out on the campaign trail today. What are we looking for?
Well, I think that the idea that Donald Trump's tone is going to change significantly on the stump, I don't think we should expect to see that, but I think we should see some adjustments. I think the amazing thing about him going to the 9/11 museum over the weekend was not just that he went there, but that there were a bunch of cameras sitting there waiting for Donald Trump to walk over and talk to them, and he skipped that opportunity. I cannot explain to you how rare it is for Donald Trump to see a bunch of cameras waiting for him and say, no, I'm going to pass, and I'm not going to talk to these guys. So I think that, you know, he can continue to go on the stump. He can continue to hammer Ted Cruz. But the question is, what does he do around that? Does he resist showing up on every single television show constantly? And like we saw over the past couple weeks, stepping on his own message. I mean, for him to be out there talking about his campaign manager getting arrested, to be taking every position on every side of the issue on abortion, that's not helpful, and they're trying to avoid that kind of thing.
They're trying to avoid that. He did call into one of the Fox News programs last night and say that, to echo what he said there, saying Ted Cruz, he thinks, hates New York. He says he thinks Ted Cruz hates New York. He tweeted out on Friday, so great to be in New York, catching up on many things. Remember, I'm still running a major business. So he was trying to make the case. He was trying to make the case that he was doing his day job, if you will. But to Sarah's point here, they're trying to get him to be a more measured, I guess is the best way to put it, a measured Donald Trump. They're also trying to make sure that he gets 50% plus, statewide in New York, and then in each of those 27 congressional districts, because you fall below 50% in a congressional district, you lose a delegate. Conceivable?
You know, I think that's one reason why Ted Cruz is actually not backing away from that New York City values comment, because in upstate New York, there is division, particularly among conservative voters in upstate New York who don't look so well on New York City. So I think that Ted Cruz believes he can pull away some support from that part of the state. I think they recognize the polling difficulties. Winning will be very difficult, but if he can win some delegates there, it could be problematic for Donald Trump if he prevents him from making it winner.
And that's why you get to see all these great scenes of Ted Cruz at a matzah factory and John Kasich eating half an Archer Avenue deli. I mean, because there's not a lot of Republicans in the Bronx, but if they can pick up, it's by congressional district, if they can keep him from hitting that 50% threshold, pick up a delegate or two, that will help them in the long run.
And so,